So now, so this is the another important and easiest topic of the network analysis is duality. Okay, duality, which was placed in the fifth unit as extension of graph theory. Extension of graph. Okay, so in this lecture, we are going to see some introductory aspects of duality and what is the concept of duality and procedure to obtain the duality of the circuits. Then some of the examples. Okay, then. So duality, the dual role, Maybe when watching so many movies with the dual roles. So dual roles means, so maybe the person who is playing a dual role, or they are of similar characteristics in terms of appearance and in terms of activities. Okay, so then they are said to be dual. Like that. So the similar kind of principle you apply to the networks also. So we have been using the KVL, KCL, which are the two fundamental powerful laws proposed by Kirchhoff. Okay, Kirchhoff voltage law and Kirchhoff current law. They are almost similar. With word of order, voltage. Okay, voltage in KVL substituted for current in KCL, and independent loop in KVL substituted for independent node in KCL. Okay, algebraic sum of all branch voltages, okay, in an independent loop is equal to zero, or in a loop is equal to zero. So here algebraic sum of the currents in independent node or in any node of a circuit is equal to zero. Okay, so therefore here the voltage is substituted for current, similar to current. The loop is similar to the node, Not only these two parameters. So as a result of KVL and KCL, so we'll get the differential and integral equations, Okay, so they also seems to be similar in the appearance, and the result also may be similar, Okay, so that's what we are going to see in the duality concept. Two circuits are said to be duals of each other if the mesh equations of one circuit have same form as the nodal equations of the other circuits. So when they are said to be duals, as the mesh equations of one equation is similar to the nodal equations of the other circuit, then they are said to be dual. When they are said to be exactly dual, if the numerical values of variables of two circuits also same, then they are said to be exactly dual. If their nature is similar, then they are said to be dual. Their exactly dual means their numerical values also should be same. Okay. Coming to identical behavior patterns observed between voltages and currents in two circuits illustrates the principle of duality. Identical behavior patterns. Between the voltage currents in two circuits illustrates the principle of duality. Okay, we'll see. Now, so for that, consider a series RLC circuit, which forms a loop. So by assuming the current I, if you apply KVL to this loop, we may get this expression: minus V plus IR plus L into DI by DT plus 1 by C integral I dt is equal to 0. Okay, integral is equal to 0. So this can be right, IR plus L into DI by DT plus 1 by C integral I dt is equal to V. Okay. So here, if these three elements arranged, in parallel, with a current source instead of a voltage source, so if you apply a nodal analysis to the circuit that gives minus I plus Vg plus C into dV by dt. Plus C into dV by dt plus L into dr, 1 by L into integral V dt is equal to 0. That is the algebraic sum of currents meeting at a node is equal to 0. Here there is only one node. Okay, we will assume the all outgoing currents are positive and incoming currents are negative. Here only current I is entering into the node and remaining currents are leaving. So that's why here plus V by R, 1 by R is equal to G, where G is conductance. That's why V by R, that 1 by R is equal to Z. So Vg, current flowing through capacitance, I is equal to C into dV by dt. Current flowing through the inductance, I is equal to 1 by L integral V dt. So this gives Vg plus C into dV by dt plus 1 by L integral V dt is equal to I. So, see, if you closely observe these two equations, so here IR is similar to Vg. IR is similar to Vg. And L into di by dt is equal to C into dV by dt. And 1 by C integral I dt is equal to 1 by L integral V dt. V is equal to I. That means, first of all, these two equations are said to be similar. These two equations are said to be similar. And the terms of the parts of each equation, the parts of these two equations also be similar. Okay. So therefore, as per the principle of duality, we saw, okay, the resulted integral differential equations of mesh and nodal analysis, nodal KVL or KCL are also seems to be similar. So therefore, these two equations are similar. And also, the parts of IR is similar to Vg, L into di by dt is similar to C into dV by dt, and this part is similar to this part. Where here the voltage is replaced by current. The voltage is replaced by current. Right side, the voltage is replaced by current. All the way, the voltage is replaced by current. So V, I, where R is equal to G. That means where G is equal to 1 by R. L di by dt, I is replaced by V and L replaced by C. Here L replaced by C, I replaced by V. So therefore, the role of current and voltage in the two networks have been interchanged. The solution of one equation also solution of other. The similarity is termed as the principle of duality. So if you solve this equation, you may get voltage, current. If you solve this equation, you may get voltage. Okay, so here the voltage is interchanged with current, the current is interchanged with voltage. So therefore, if we solve this equation, okay, the solution of this equation is current, the solution of this equation is again voltage. Those two also interchange. So this seems to be the principle of duality. Okay, now, so this is what we observe and we wrote here. By looking into the above two equations, it is also observed that the resistance, inductance, capacitance in the original network, okay, appears in the dual network as resistance as a conductance, inductance as capacitance, capacitance as inductance respectively with the same numerical values. Okay. So therefore, what we observed here, see, the resistance replaced by the conductance, inductance replaced by the capacitance replaced by the inductance. Here the voltage replaced by current. And the series connection replaced by a parallel connection. Here we applied a KVL. here we apply KCL. So these are these what we observed. All these changes are said to be analogous to each other. Analogous to each other are similar to each other are also called dual elements. Dual elements. Okay, that's what we observed. Okay. So therefore, these are the sum of the analogous elements. Analogous are dual elements of one other element in the network analysis. What we observed so far. So here, see, voltage is dual element for current. For resistance, the conductance has a dual element. For inductance, capacitance has a dual element. For KVL, KCL has a dual one. And mesh equations appears to be nodal equation. A series circuit may be replaced by a parallel circuit. An open circuit should be replaced by a short circuit. Coming to Thevenin's, Thevenin's will be replaced by Norton's. Okay. And a tree, coming to graph theory, a tree, for a tree, the dual element is co-tree, which is a complement. For a twig, a complement is link. A tie set, its complement is cut set. Okay. And we also observed the dual elements in the resonance. I talked about a brief about duality, especially while talking about the quality factor. The quality factor of series resonance is omega L by R 1 by omega CR. Q is equal to omega L by R, which is equal to 1 by omega CR. Whereas coming to parallel resonance, the same quality factor Q is equal to R by omega L omega CR, which is inverse of the series resonance circuit, series RL resonance circuit. That's what is called duality. Okay, the series resonance. Okay, exactly. So these two, when we consider these two circuits as the series RLC circuit and parallel RLC circuit. Okay, so this is what the principle of duality. Okay. Now, so therefore, how to obtain a dual network for the given network. So therefore, here, if you observe, this has a dual concept of duality. So here, in place of one loop, for a series RLC circuit, for its dual network, one loop may be replaced by one node. One loop may be replaced by only one node. All the series elements will be present in the parallel. Okay, between loop and reference. Here there is only single loop, but here there are two nodes. One is active node, and another one is reference node. So we have to recall the basics of graph theory. Okay, while drawing graph, we have to assume one more node apart from active nodes. Actually, here it is only one node, but you have to select one more node as a reference node to get its dual network. Okay, so you have to connect all the series elements present in the series loop. Okay, between the active node and reference node as a parallel elements. With this basics, we are going to frame some rules to get the dual network of any given network. Okay, we'll see that. The procedure to get the dual circuit. The first one, inside each loop, place a node and give it a number for all loops for convenience. So you have to place each node, one node in each loop. If circuit consists of three loops, you have to place three nodes corresponding to each loop. There are four loops, you have to place four nodes corresponding to each loop. After that, place an extra node called reference node, which is external to the network, say zero node. So after placing active nodes corresponding to loops, you have to take one more node called reference node, which is placed outside the circle, and draw a line between two nodes of the original network traversing only one element at a time. Okay, so based on the connection of elements of actual network, you have to join those two nodes, okay, for one element at a time. For each element traversed in the original network, connect the dual elements from the listing just given on the dual network being constructed. So continue this process until the number of possible paths through the single element is exhausted. So you have to repeat the same procedure. So depending upon the actual connection of elements in the actual network, you have to connect, okay, one element at a time in the dual network between the nodes. Here between the loops appears between the nodes. Okay, you have to connect all the elements present in the actual network in the dual network. So once it is completed, okay, the result network will be treated as a dual network for the actual network. Okay, now we'll see so that you can get a better idea. Okay, now, so obtain the dual network for the figure 1 shown below. So here, so the circuit is given and he asked to find its dual network. So here, as per the procedure, first we need to identify how many loops are there, and you need to place one node corresponding to one loop. So how many loops are there here? Here there are three loops. Suppose say loop 1, loop 2, and loop 3. Say for example, this is say loop 1, and this is say loop 2, and this is say loop 3. Okay, so loop 1, loop 2, loop 3. You call it as some say 1 and 2 and 3. Okay, and assume all loop currents are in clockwise direction. Okay. Now you have to place a node corresponding to each loop. Okay, here one node, here another node, here another. And you also place one more node externally, which is called reference node. Maybe like this. Okay, see here, in the first loop there is a first node, second loop there is a second node, third loop there is a third node, and you need to place one more node as a reference node to the external of the circuit. Okay, maybe somewhere here, called reference node. Now you have to join the element, one element at a time, depending upon its existence between the loops. Suppose here, if you come to here, see first one, between loop one and two, there is a capacitance. For a capacitance, the dual element is inductance. So therefore, this capacitance will be replaced by an inductance between these two nodes. So join 1 and 2 with a capacitance. So here it is C1, then represent with L1. Now, between 1 and 3, there is a resistance. For resistance, the dual element is conductance. So therefore, join 1 and 3, with conductance G1. Okay, and coming to here, see the element the self element, the individual element. This is these two are mutual elements between 1-2 and 1-3. But this is individual element in the loop 1 or outer loop element. So this may be connected between the actual node and reference node. Actual node and reference node. Okay, here it is a voltage source. Okay, maybe replace it by a current source. Current source and direction is clockwise direction. Direction is clockwise direction. So therefore, you have to take clockwise direction, upward direction. Okay, between active node and reference node. Active node and reference node with the current source. The voltage source should be replaced by a current source. So therefore, the first loop is over. Now come to second loop. In the second loop, if you come to mutual element C1, it is already connected. Then come to between 2 and 3. Between 2 and 3, there is an inductor L. Inductor L. For inductor, the dual element is capacitor. So you join 2 and 3 with a capacitor C. The capacitor C. Now, okay, it is over. These two are over. Coming to only R2 present in the second loop, which is the outer part of the loop as a self element. Okay, so therefore, this should be connected between the node 2 and reference. Node 2 and reference. For R2, the analogous element is G2. So connect G2 between 2 and 0. Between 2 and 0, Z2. And come to third loop. Third node R1 L already completed. And come to C2 only remains, but it is in the outer loop as a self element. So this C2 should be connected between this node and reference node. This node and reference node. C2. For C2, analogous element is L2. So therefore, from node 3, there is a connection to the reference. Okay, this C2 should be replaced by L2. Okay. So therefore, then we completed each and every element present in the actual network. So this completes the duality of the network. Okay. This is the dual element of it. Dual network of the given network. You just draw simply the dual network by taking the nodes. So how many nodes are there? There are three nodes. So place 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, and 3. Okay. It's all convenience. 1, 2, and 3. Between 1 and 2, there is an inductor L1. 1 and 2, there is an inductor L1. 1 and 3, there is a G1. 3 and 2, there is a C. Okay. And 1 and reference, the current source I, and 2 and reference, there is a G2, so there is a G2, and 3 and reference, there is an L2, you have to connect like this. Okay, so after placing the nodes, 1, 2, 3, you just join these elements. Okay, without any crossover. Is it clear? Okay. Now you come to, we'll see the one doubt. Very good. Okay, no doubt. Okay, it's okay. Okay, now if you go to, we'll see one more problem. So you obtain dual network for the figure one shown below. So it is somewhat a simple problem compared to previous one. Okay, so here also similarly obtain how many loops are there. So there are two loops. So therefore, place two nodes in the two loops. So here one node, here another node. Okay, you need to take one more node as a reference node to the external of the circuit. So like this. So here, 1, 2, and 3. This is reference node. First node corresponding to first loop. Second node corresponding to second loop. Then you have to join the elements. See here, between loop 1 and 2, there is a current source. Which is driving current in clockwise direction. So therefore, you have to take the, this current source should be replaced by a voltage source between 1 and 2 that has to drive current in clockwise direction. Because it is driving current in clockwise direction. Okay. So therefore, take the voltage source and take this polarities similar to this current direction. And there is no mutual element between these two. Except this one. Is it right? Now, in the first loop, there are three elements present there as a self elements, as individual elements. So these three are in series. So therefore, these three may appear in parallel. Between the active node and reference node. That's what I have drawn here. Okay. From first loop. So if you take first voltage source, it is driving current in clockwise direction. So the upward direction. So therefore, you take this voltage source may be replaced by a current source between active node and reference node. Okay. With a current source of same magnitude. Because they are exactly dual. 5 amperes. And coming to this inductor. For inductor, analogous element is capacitor. So therefore, you have to draw a capacitor like this. Between 1 and 0. And a capacitor. 1 farad. It should be replaced by 1 Henry inductor. Between 1 and reference. So like this here also, these three series elements may appear in parallel between this active node and reference node. For 2 ohm, again 2 mohs, here see units, here it is in mohm, resistance, that should be replaced by conductance for unit, conductance is mho. So 2 ohms, 2 mhos. Then 1 Henry, 1 farad, 1 farad, 1 Henry. 1 farad, 1 Henry. So these three are in parallel. And it should present between these two. Now, so this seems to be your dual network. There are two nodes. Between these two nodes, a voltage source of 1 volt connected like this, and remaining all elements are connected in parallel. Okay, these three elements connected in parallel between 1 and 0, and these three elements connected between 2 and 0 as a parallel. Okay, so you check once again. Okay, I hope it's clear. Now we'll discuss one more problem on this, then we'll close it. See, the units are very important here. It is ohm, it is mho. It is mho. And the direction is also important. And if you take the another problem, obtain the dual network for the figure 1 shown below. So this is the given figure 1. So here also there are three loops. There are three loops. Maybe is a loop 1. Okay. And it is loop 2. And it is loop 3. Loop 3. You may take directions like this. Maybe directions maybe clockwise. You have to treat you have to take three nodes. This is one node, and this is one more node. Okay, and this is okay, na? So like this. This is first node, second node, and third node. Here the elements are not drawn, but only paths drawn. Okay, based on that we will draw the circuit. Draw the circuit. Okay. Now see here. First node, second node, third node. Between first and second, there is a capacitor. For capacitor, the analogous element is inductor. Okay, here inductor comes into picture. And between one and three, there is an inductor L1. Okay. In place of inductor, you may get a capacitor of value C1. So here C1 comes into picture. Between 2 and 3, there is an R2. This may be replaced by a conductance G2. Between these two, you will get a conductance G2. Paths are only given here. So there is no other mutual element. Coming to first loop, there are three elements which are in series as a self elements. So you have to replace, you have to connect these three between first active node and reference node. Here in this path. You have to connect these three elements. So how they should be connected? Whether they should be in series or parallel. Actually here these three are in parallel. These three are in series. So you have to replace these three. Okay, in parallel between first node and reference node. Here this also driving current, in clockwise direction. So therefore here your current direction is upwards. And coming to second loop, here L2, R3, these two are connected in series as a self elements. So these were in series. So they will appear in parallel. L2 replaced by C2, R3 replaced by G3. Coming to third loop, here there is a current source as an individual element, okay, between tree and reference. But this direction is opposite to the clockwise direction. So therefore, your direction may be, voltage source direction may be downwards. Upward direction, because this current also driving upward direction. Okay. So this seems to be. Okay, so here see, between 1 and 2, the capacitor replaced by inductor. Between 2 and 3, R2 replaced by G2. Between 1 and 3, L1 replaced by C1. L1 replaced by C1. Okay, and coming to these three. These three are in series. Okay, switcher. Switch also treat one element. So I have to treat switch as one element. Okay, switch, voltage source and resistance. These three are in series. So R1 may be replaced by G1. G1. Switch as open, you have to again open switch. Okay. And voltage source should be replaced by a current source. Current source. Okay, direction is upward direction. Now, coming to the second loop, there are two elements present in the series. They will become in parallel. L2 replaced by C2, R3 replaced by G3. C2, G3. Now, this is the current source. This current source driving current in the opposite direction. Okay. So therefore, here actually here the source direction is taken as downward direction. The clockwise direction. So you should take this direction is opposite. Direction is opposite. Plus and minus. Plus and minus. Okay. That's all. So with this, I will complete the 50 unit. Okay. So if you have any doubts, ask me regarding it. So you have to do, I think this problem is repeated. You need not do it.